Hi, my name is Riata Scott, and I'm with the Division of IT's IT Training Department at the University of Missouri, Columbia. Today I'm going to show you how to create an InDesign template. Templates are useful if your publication is formatted the same way every time you create it, and all you're doing is changing the content. So in this exercise, we'll create a new document, load the masters and styles from an existing document, and save it as an InDesign template. So we'll go up to File, and hover New, and choose Document. Number of pages, I'm going to give that 8 pages. Page size, I'll go with letter half. Portrait orientation, and my margins, I want 1 pica 6 points. And I don't really need a bleed, but I'll just add 1 pica 6 as well. And then I'll click OK. Now we'll open the Pages panel menu, and hover Master Pages, and choose Load Master Pages. So when you create a document and you've made your master pages and they're great, and you know you're going to want to use them in another document, you don't have to save your master pages out. You just save them in that document, and that's where they are. And if you ever want to load those master pages into a new document, all you have to do is go into the panel menu, load master pages, and find the document that you want the master pages from. And I think it was in here. And it was the Como Zoo Animal Facts. That's the one I want, so I'll just select that and click Open. And notice these pages have been added up here, so that's great. And then we can apply them. So I'm just going to grab the cover thumbnail, and when I see the dark band around that thumbnail, I'll let go. And let's grab the back cover, put it there. And then I'll drag these. I do not have luck dragging a whole spread, so I drag one at a time. I am not sure what I changed in my settings, or if that's just something that happened in the new version. But you see this one says A, so I still messed something up. So I'm going to grab that again, redo that one. They need to all have the P in the corner that lets us know that we've applied the correct master page. So now all of these have the correct master page on them. Paragraph styles, I have almost nothing right now, so I'm going to load paragraph styles as well, and that works just the same way as master pages, except that we look at a different menu. So we'll open paragraph styles, open the menu, and choose load paragraph styles. And again, I'm going to choose Como Zoo Animal Facts because that was a document that had the master pages and the paragraph styles that I set up ahead of time. So when we choose this actual document, it will only bring in the paragraph styles from it and not the rest of the content. So we'll click Open. And we'll get this Load Styles dialog that lets us check for anything that might be a problem, any conflicts. But this is fine. I've tested it before, so I'm just going to click OK. So now we have actual paragraph styles in here as well. So all is well. Looks like we have a little problem with our linked images and things, so let me go to links, and I'll just select one of those and choose to relink. And now I apologize, but I have to find that. Oops, I think it's here. Was that the logo I just tried? Oops, let's just try that. Okay, that one's fixed, and hopefully these are all in the same place. So again, I'll select one, click the link button. Backgrounds and graphics, I believe that's where that is. And say open, and I actually should have selected all of these and then relinked. All right, so that one, I am not sure why that's grayed out, search for missing links in this folder. That usually makes things very easy, but again, I'm doing this on a different computer, and so things may not be set up quite the same way as they usually are. So I'll just click open. comes right back and lets me pick giraffe and bird PSD. That's this one. And last, I need address only, and actually that is back one. Common Zoo, address only, open. All right, so all of that is fixed. So presumably we have a well-functioning template now with areas for all of our content. And right now it's just a regular document, so we're going to turn that into a template now. So we'll just go to File and Save As, and I'll just place it here. That's fine. I'm going to call this, I can't remember the name of that document. Was it Animal Facts? Good enough. And we'll just say template. And then Save As Type. This is INDD, which is InDesign Document. We don't want that. We want INDT, which is InDesign Template. So click that and click Save. So right now this is an INDT, and if we any edits that we make to it would be on the actual template. But I'm finished for now. Everything looks good to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and close this. And then I'll show you when we're ready. It's next season and we're doing our, I don't know, our winter Animal Facts newsletter. We would open up, go to File and Open. And notice we have our, where did I put that? I think I put it back one. Sorry about that. Animal Facts template here. So I'll select that, click Open. And it opens up as untitled-6 or whatever number you're on, depending on how long you've had the document open that day. And that's a regular document. So that means that we can come in here and fill in content and save it and not worry about messing up our template, which is something I used to do all the time when I created a template that was just a document and I had to open it up. I'd add the content in, forget to save as, and then I'd have to go back in and take everything back out and turn it back into a template when I was finished. This way, we're not in danger of that. However, if you did want to update the template, you could open it this way and do something. Let's say I don't want that place TOC here anymore, so I'm going to Control-Shift to select that and just say delete. And I want this to be part of the template. I want the template to no longer have that text frame, so I could go up to File, Save As, and choose INDT template. I'll just click that because I want that name populated there, and so that when I say save, it will save over the old version. So I'll click Save. It asks me if I want to replace it. Yes, I do. So that's all there is to it. We saved that one as an INDT, but we could have just opened it up and had that untitled one, put all of our content in it, and just saved it as a new name, Animal Facts Winter 2016 or whatever.